Everyone, assalamu alaikum. And here we'll take a look how to use Google Map to search address. For example, here I am. Now it takes me to a new page over here. Now as I try to type over on it, so I can see that I have a list of addresses. So I can type in any kind of address anywhere in the world, it doesn't matter. Say for example, we do Bangladesh, Dhaka. So here, well, we have a list of addresses and we would be able to select them. Or right now, I would go back to Shanghai position because this is where I am. Shanghai, China. Well, I would pick any of the place where I want. Okay. Say, for example, this one. So as you see, it gets loaded and it takes me over here. So this is the kind of result that we want to achieve. Okay. Of course, we can go ahead and save it, all right? So as you see, we save it, we can see it over here, all right? Well, anyway, so yeah, this is what we want to achieve. Well, to get started, we would come over here. Let's go ahead and create a new project, which I have already done. Well, after creating new project, you have to go ahead and get your Google API key, and I have another tutorial for that. If you don't know how to do that, go ahead and check the link below, all right? And then get the key and find this file which is called app-delegate.swift and put it to your key over here within this syntax. Okay, that's for iOS and for Android. Pretty much the same thing. Get your key and put your key over here, right below this end of this application tag. So with this, we are done with getting the key and basic setup. Now we need to install some plugins. While over here, we are going to use this few plugins, okay? Get for state management, HTTP for HTTP request like post and get, and then geolocator, geocoding, and Google Maps Flutter for showing Google and showing Google Map, and Flutter Google Places for showing the places as you try to type on this and you see the places, and as well as this one for auto completion. Okay, all right, so go ahead and install them. Well, after that, we created a new Dart file which is called location controller.dart, and over here I'm using getx controller, so we extend it so that we'd be able to use this controller for our class management and state management, and as well as we have imported all the necessary files that we need. All right, so you can do them step by step as we work ahead, but I just decided to go ahead and import them. And then we declared some variables. Now we have this place mark and prediction, but now both of them are coming from the packages that we have installed. Now place mark would help us to get address specific code from a string, so that we can use it later. So all we need to do later on, pass card kind of certain string to it, which we'll see later. Now prediction, once again, this would be coming from Flutter Maps, Google Maps web services over here. Okay, so with this prediction, you'd be able to, like as you can see, you'd be able to get the predicted places as you hover over on it and try to type things, okay, like that. So this is where the prediction, this API helps you. Okay, so we'll have a list of places. So that's why we declare a list over here, because for each search, you'll have maybe few places or a lot more. Whatever the places you see, you will put them in a list like this. And after that, over here, we created a method named search location. It will take two items and its parameters, or two parameters. And then, of course, we have a method, but this method is not there yet, which we'll create. And then, of course, over here, we'll get response from this method. And then we'll decode it. But this method we are going to create very soon. And then whatever we get over here, we'll check the status code. If the status code is okay, from this data, the data we get after decoding, we'll loop through it and put them in this list. Okay, do remember, each time you try to type in, this method gets called, So each time this list would be initialized from the scratch, because each time you might have a different place and a list of places. Now over here we have prediction dot from JSON. Once again, this is coming from API, the library or the packages that we have installed earlier. So you don't need to worry about it. So anyway, so each time you click on this one over here, this method would get called from our UI, and then it'll loop, then it'll talk to the server using this one, and server would give us a response. And once you get the response, we will check and loop through it and try to save in this prediction list, and then we'll return. So now we'll go ahead and create this method. So over here, I have created a new Dart file, which is called location.dart, as you can see over here. And then I have created this method, which is called getLocation. Now it takes a string. Now this is the string that would be passed from here. Now this string, for now, we can go ahead and import it. Now the error should be gone. So this would be called from UI. As we call, the text would be passed from there, and the same text will pass it to our function or method over here. And this method eventually would be called over here. And over here we have this http.get, which will talk to our server using this URI. Now you should have a valid URI from your side as well. Okay. Or you can also try to do it in localhost, but here I'm directly do it in a server that I have this endpoint. Okay. All right. Now later on at the end, we'll show you the endpoint. So anyway, so from here, this method gets called. It talks to this server first, and from the server, eventually it talks to the Google server. Now how it talks to the Google server, I'll tell you later at the end of this tutorial. And then after talking to the Google server, it returns us a response, and then we return the response. And this response is kept over here, or set over here, and then we loop through it. After that, we'll go ahead and create our UI. So map screen is a stateful class, and over here at the top I have defined this camera position, which will initialize it later, and which do it in init state. After that, we do have a Google controller and an instance of it, and right after that we wrap everything around this get builder, and get builder takes a class type, which is location controller. Since we are using getx, so we use get builder. Now at the same time, we create an instance of this location controller, which is this one. Right after that, we have this basic app bar. And now here is the most important part. So we in the body, we have this stack, and over here we have this Google map. Now as map is created, it saves in this global variable, which is map controller, which we have seen earlier over here. And then at the same time, we also assign this camera position. Now, first time when we load our app, our camera position is hard-coded, as you can see from here. And after that, we have this positioned widget. And inside this, actually, nothing fancy. We do have a gesture detector, and inside it, we have this container. Now this would be most important later, but for now it's empty, and we have some basic padding and decoration. This doesn't really matter. Okay, now over here we have this expanded widget, and this is where we actually want to show the typed in messages after selection. So like for example, once you select, this is where you want to show, and this is the place where the magic happens for showing. Now this variable, actually place mark, we have already defined over here, as you can see. So this variable is red over here once again. And then we have this icon for making it beautiful. By the way, you can also get the code from the link below, so don't worry, just follow along with me. Now from main.dart, we'll call this map screen, which is this one, the one that we created just now. And after that, we'll restart our app to get this new project and show everything from the scratch. Now at this moment, if you go ahead and run the app, you will get this error. Now here it says that controller not found. Now the reason is that we have a controller over here, but we didn't inject it at the top. So inside this, we inject our dependency, and at the same time, we make sure that our dependency has been imported. And right after that, we also need to wrap our material app using get, so it becomes get material app, since we are using getex package. Now let's run it, and this is what we see, and this is what we are supposed to see. Okay, now this section is actually coming from here. So we have this gesture detector. Of course, if we try to write over here, nothing will happen. Now for this one, we need to write some other class and events. So once you tap on this, this event gets triggered. So over here, we created a new file called location-search-dialog.dart. So over for in this file, we have a stateless class. Now inside this, we have this container. And right before it, we have this text editing controller, which would be triggered for this one. And then we have this type ahead field. Now this is coming from a package that we have installed earlier. Now this would help us to do auto completion. But do remember, this is more like a text field, but more sophisticated one where you get auto completion. Now over here for text editing, we created a controller and we are passing the controller to this controller. And rest of the thing is basic styling and designing. Once again, you can get the code below from the link, so don't worry. Now, what I wanted you to see over here, this is the most important part. So this callback gets called whenever you touch and try to click or try to type in over here. So over here, a function can get called, okay? Now here we do see that we have a function. So this is the search location function that gets called. Now where is this function? This function is over here, search location. So what's happening over here, as you try to type over here, click in, so this text field, type ahead field, gets triggered. And in return, over here, this callback gets triggered, and as it gets triggered, we can call or do anything we want. So in our case, we are calling our method inside this location controller. So location controller will get the data from the Google server. Now, as we type in things over here, this type ahead can keep track of what we are typing, and that catches that and put in this pattern variable. You can name it anything, it doesn't matter. Eventually, if you go to this search location class, actually this is a string. So once again, if you try to type in, this callback gets called, so we can go ahead and talk to anyone we want. And right after that, we have this item builder. Now item builder helps you to get the list of items on the screen and show you. Now as it returns a value, as you can see. It returns a list of values over here. Now those values are so saved in this prediction API, which has an instance called suggestion. You can name it anything. So this prediction API, the suggestion variable, can get hold all the data that's returned from here. So as it returned from here, saved everything here, we can access the information, whatever we want, using a field called description. Well, there are a lot of other fields, but description field is the most important one. And it shows everything in a list one by one, like a list view builder. Now it's time for us to go ahead and connect this onTap event. Now here I'll have onTap event like this. So here is my onTap event, and here is my location search dialog. Now location search dialog is the file, the Dart file that we created. So get dialog would show everything on a screen at the top as a dialog. Okay, as long as we try to type in. So it calls this one. Okay, all we need to do, pass our map controller or our Google map, which is we catch over here. Okay, now let's go ahead and restart our app one more time. So let's go ahead and try to type in. So here we can do Shanghai. So we'll see a list of options for Shanghai, we'll for Dhaka. So this is where I'm from. We can also see for New York. Okay, so whatever the city you want, and it's working. So we can see the live update over here. So let's go ahead and see. Say we do Beijing. So as you see, we have the data Beijing live from here. Okay, like China, Beijing. So these are the places that we see. So basically you can find location for any place in the world as long as that's in Google Map. Okay, so yes, so that's how you go ahead and see the data for Google Map. Well, so that's how you go ahead and implement Google Map and search for location. Now it's time to see the back end. Now this is the server side code that's get called, and I'm using Laravel. So I have an endpoint which is called Place API Autocomplete, and the search item or text is sent to it, and request can get it from request object. Now this is the endpoint as same as this one, as you can see over here. So we are using the same endpoint. Now I'm not sure what server side you are doing. So whatever it is, the basic idea should be the same. So what's the idea? The idea is you sent the search item, the one you want to search for. Okay, so in this get request, and then you server side should be able to get it. It doesn't matter what server side you use it, so they all should be get it in a certain object. And then all you need to do inside server side, you need to use another get request. Okay, now inside this get request, this is the Google Map API that you should use. Okay, and from your request object or whatever object is there for you, get the search item. Okay, and send your key as well. You should be good to go. Okay, well, in next part, we'll see how to save it.